Now that we've solved the photo manager challenge in the United Exploitation area, I thought about checking out Casino. Should also not be too hard with 150 points. Welcome to our casino, Riskure Royale. Please enjoy your stay by playing a game or drink something at our bar. Reach 1000 credits and you will be rewarded with a special prize. We have seen loads of cheaters lately, so we have extra guards walking around. Do not feel threatened by them, they will only kick out the people that cheat. Of course, once you earn a lot of money, they will start investigating the matter. Better spend some money at our bar if this happens. P.S. We all know casinos are scams. As you know, I'm hanging out on the rhme2 IRC channel, and I witnessed a conversation some time ago by somebody who worked on the challenge and asked if it's possible to reach the 1000 credits through playing and just getting lucky. But this person also said they tried running it for days, I think, and it didn't work. So while it's not a real spoiler, it does save us some time to not explore that path. You could have also come to that conclusion reading the PS, but it's not that clear. Anyway, let's flash the challenge onto the board with AVR Dude and connect to it over serial with screen. Welcome to the casino. Get a currency of 1000 and we give you the secret key. That's what we want. Occasionally we will give away coupons for free drinks, we have guards walking around looking for cheaters, don't get caught cheating, or we will take our currency back. Currently we got 50 credits and no coupons. And the menu offers to play, to cheat, go for a drink at the bar, request some free money or restart. When we pick play, we can choose between roulette or spin the wheel. If we pick roulette, we can enter a number, and in this case I entered the wrong one. The ball landed on 28 and we lost. And we are down 1 credit. If we spin the wheel, it seems like we have a chance to win the secret key, and I guess that's what the person on IRC just tried to do over and over again for hours, but casinos are scam, right? But we did win a coupon. Awesome. Let's try roulette again. Nothing. And obviously if we pick cheat, we get kicked out. So let's start over. Spin the wheel and oops, we lost our credit. But when we ask for free money, we get another 50. Maybe we can just get up to 1000 this way. Let's request more money. Only let us go up to 550. But that's already pretty awesome. So let's go play and spin the wheel, 110. If we keep going like this, we get the 1000 for sure. Another coupon. Maybe let's go for a drink at the bar. We can type in our drink now, Club Mate of course. We can hand in the coupon and get that drink. So here we have some string input that's definitely something to consider exploring further. Without a coupon, it seems to only offer us milk or beer. So let's pick the only viable option, beer. Didn't do much. So, if we can't get 1000 by just playing and getting lucky, the only interesting input so far seems to be going to the bar if we have a coupon. So let's write a script to explore that input further. So this is the menu structure. To choose a drink, we need to get a coupon. So upon starting it up, we read the menu until it's done with printing it, then we select play and we read until the menu is finished printing. And then we spin the wheel and with a bit of luck we get a coupon. And when we try now, it seems to work fairly well. But we can have bad luck and lose all credit. We could also see what happens if we succeed with roulette. So let's change the menu selection to roulette and pick a number and try that over and over again until we hit it. Maybe that can give us a coupon. By only consuming 1 credit for each spin, we don't lose everything with like the wheel. So we make a loop to try it over and over again until we read that we have now 1 coupon. Let's run it. And yeah, that works. So we can now add user input. So we can then play with the drinks at the bar. Okay, that also works, cool. So let's see what happens if we enter a lot of A's. It looks like there's limited space. As you can see, the echoed back A's are way less than what we entered. Also, we don't get an error. So let's do this again, but this time enter a different payload. Always when a program prints out user input, you should try out format strings. So let's enter some percentage x. And what a surprise, we print some numbers. This worked. And if you decode those hex values, you will see that it's the input string we entered, the %x itself. To leak data with a format string, it would be cool to place an address on our input and then use %s to use that address as a string location. This way we could dump the whole memory. So let's enter some recognizable characters and see where they are. And it's easy, the start of our string is already where the format parameters will be. So the first x printed AB and the second x printed CD. If we now use %s instead, it will use hex 4142 AB as an address and print the string at that location. Huh, awesome! AB, CD are already valid string locations. And by sheer luck, we already hit a string in memory. The guards are keeping an eye on you. That's awesome. So this definitely works. Now all we gotta do is create a loop that simply tries to print as many strings as possible by trying different addresses. So let's create a loop that simply counts up all the addresses and just leaks strings from everything. I guess it's best if we do it this way. We open a new connection and then we try to get a coupon. So we spin the roulette multiple times, and if we succeed, we continue to try out an address, and then we repeat. Also, I add some code to really extract the leaked string, and then we can move the address forward based on the length we leaked, so we don't like read the same string at different offsets all the time. It's faster this way. Oh, and we also know that A, B, and CD were valid addresses that leaked strings. So let's use that as a start address. And in case we run out of credit and didn't get a coupon, we just reset the game again. So let's run it. This looks really cool. We leak all those strings, awesome. But when I let it run for a bit, I never saw a flag. And I decided to maybe it's better to start from the beginning. So I entered the start address 0101. Because I didn't want to have null bytes in the string, so that's the first valid address. And surprisingly, there it is. We found it almost immediately. Awesome. So let's hand in the flag, casino solved.